everyone, it's Amanda with AmandaFrances.com. Today I have a great topic for you, something that applies to all of us. It is how to get over absolutely anything. Be a breakup, something that's bothering you, a loss, a friendship that ended, someone that's no longer in your support system anymore, how to get over something that is plaguing you right now. Okay, step one, accept yourself where you're at. Give yourself permission to feel how you feel today, to be where you are today. If you're not over something that you feel like you should be over by now, I would guess that you're judging yourself for it probably a little bit, maybe beating yourself up, maybe doing the why am I not over this, what the F is wrong with me, just being hard on yourself. And the problem is that judgment, those negative thoughts can spin us into like a crazy spiral, which brings me to step two. Figure out what your detour thought is. So your detour thought is when you go into crazy town. So it might start off, number one, oh, I really miss my ex-boyfriend. Like, I miss him, like he smelled so good and his V-necks were so soft, and I miss cuddling and I miss movie nights and I miss getting takeout and like whatever, a normal thought where you just like feel something. And then you go, what the F is wrong with me? Why am I not over him? I'll never love again. I'm gonna be single for life. I can't trust men. Only idiot guys are in my city. There's no one here for me. We go into the crazy town downward spiral. So notice your trigger thought, the trigger thought that takes you from your totally perfect, normal, where you're at thought, you go into a place of judgment, into a place of fear, into a place of not accepting yourself, and you go into crazy town, and then you feel like shit because you're thinking about everything that's wrong with the situation and all your worst fears. The way you feel is fine. There's nothing wrong with the way you feel. It's the belief that you should or shouldn't feel that way, the judgment you put on yourself, the criticalness that you let run rampant in your mind that is the problem. That's what's keeping you stuck. So step three, now that you know what your trigger thought is, let's make a mantra. Like when I was starting a business and I was scared to death, like who am I to start a business? What if I don't make money? Like what if it doesn't work out? Like blah, 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 blah. My mantra was, my work is of high service and worthy of compensation. So those words weren't just words I said to shut my brain up, though. When I say those words, I feel abundant, I feel successful, I feel purposeful, I feel like I can do it. So that mantra brought up the feelings in me that I wanted to feel instead of feeling afraid. So if your fear is based around like, there's no one out there for me, I'll never love again, how do you want to feel instead of that? So if you're thought brings up a fear of being alone, your mantra should combat that. If your thought brings up a fear of not being good enough, your mantra should combat that. But it's not just a serenity now like thing. It's not just like rejecting your thought. It is a mantra. It is feeling the way you want to feel. So if you're trying to get over a man, it might be something like, though I am sad and I miss him and I feel like I will never love again, I love myself completely. I love myself fully. I accept myself. I know I'm going to be okay. You know, the right person's coming at the right time. I look forward to feeling in love again. I know that there are people out there for me and the right one is on its way. Whatever it is for you. So go ahead and pick out some words that feel the way you would like to feel and begin to integrate that into your life. No step four, but a little bonus is one thing to do is to put reminders on your phone that either pop up through certain times a day or pop up at certain locations. I always set mine to pop up at certain locations. So whatever negative fear-based thought I'm trying to work through, I have little mantras that pop up when I leave my house, when I get to my house, when I leave Starbucks, when I leave my office. And in your reminders section on your iPhone, there's a place to put your reminders on location. Okay, so I hope this helped you. and speaks to where you're at in life. Remember, you are never stuck. You can work through anything. You can change any thought. You can overcome any negative belief system. Like, you're good enough. You're worth it. This is easy. Ask to see things differently. Ask for a shift in perception and know you will be guided. As always, you can find me at XO Amanda Francis on Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, and Instagram. Oh, I have a Tumblr now too, which is also XO Amanda Francis. My blog is amandafrancis.com. This was your weekly wisdom drop. You can subscribe to get these in your inbox at amandafrancis.com. There's a little box in the corner that my virtual assistant, Megan, who is amazing, go to modernworldconsulting.com to check her out. My virtual assistant made me a little box. And you subscribe, and then the wisdom drops come in your email every week. Yay! Okay, love you. Thanks for watching. Bye.